Hello guys, welcome to my channel HVR Tutorials. Today in this video we will discuss about introduction to Selenium. So this video will not focus anything on technical. This video is entirely of what Selenium is basically, because see, in the market you hear this name a lot. Some people say Selenium can do anything, Selenium is the best tool for web automation, Selenium is blah 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 blah. So what exactly this Selenium is? So before getting into the Selenium course, we should know what this Selenium is, because see, if you want to go to some place or something, we will just inquire about the place and we'll see what is the place specialty for, what kind of food is available there, what is the best places to visit in the place, right? So similarly, before learning Selenium also, we should know a little background about Selenium. So what this tool is all about and how this Selenium is came into picture. So we'll see today what is Selenium and how this came into picture. So basically, Selenium is an open source tool that is used for automating web applications. So what is meant by web application? Web application in the sense, an application which can run in the browser. So you have so many browsers, right? Like Google Chrome, Internet Explorer, and blah, blah, blah. The application which is developed to run under a browser is called the web application. So this Selenium helps us in automating the web applications. So what is meant by automating? So let's say like you are just doing some registration in one application. Okay. So what you will do, you will enter the username, first name, last name, gender, and your username, password, blah, blah, right? So then you will click on the register button. So here manually you are doing the process, but what if the system is doing it for you? So that is called the automation. So first you write the script or you record the steps, and then next time whenever you want to do the registration, you can simply run that script and system will do the registration for you. In a simple words, it will just mimic the user's actions. So user no need to sit in front of the system and perform the actions. System will do it for you. So that is called the automation. So this Selenium do the web application automation. So Selenium is not a single tool. Selenium is consisted of multiple components, all this together called as Selenium suite. So Selenium has four components in it. First, Selenium IDE. Then comes the Selenium RC, remote control. Then Selenium WebDriver, which is the most popular one nowadays. And then Selenium Grid. So this is also most popular one nowadays. Every individual tool component in this Selenium suite is having different purpose. Okay. So it is designed to cater different needs. So it's on us to choose what we want to work with. So now we'll see what is the history of Selenium. So basically Selenium is started. This development of Selenium started in a company called ThoughtWorks. So there is a guy called Jason Huggins. So he started developing this Selenium. So basically this started as an internal automation tool. It is not intended to start as an outside open source big tool or something like that. It is developed as an internal automation tool inside ThoughtWorks. So whatever the applications they have in ThoughtWorks, they just wanted to automate them. So that is the purpose of this internal automation framework. So they started like that, and then later some other persons or developers and testers, so they also joined Jason Huggins. So they liked the concept of this framework and they slowly started supporting to Jason Huggins. So along with them, there is another guy whose name is Paul Hammond. Okay. So he joined ThoughtWorks and he also started developing this internal framework. All these people combinedly released one product called Selenium RC. That is meant by Selenium Remote Control. So for your information, the development of this tool has started in 2004. Then in 2005, they open sourced it and they released this Selenium RC. Okay, then Jason Huggins moved into Google Corporation in 2007. So he just moved from ThoughtWorks to Google, but still he is supporting and developing the Selenium RC. At that point of time, once they open source this tool, so for example, if you open source any tool, so that tool will definitely have some representatives to take care. Okay, it will not be binded under any some company or something, but though there will be some people who are monitoring that tool, right? So at that point of time, Jason Huggins and Paul Hammant were the representatives for this Selenium RC tool. There is another guy called Simon Stewart. So he started developing another product called webdriver in ThoughtWorks company. So then later that year, there is a test conference happened. So in the test conference, the developers from the ThoughtWorks and the developers from the Google, they both had a meeting. Then they decided to merge the Selenium RC and webdriver products. And then they named it as Selenium webdriver. So this happened in 2009. So by the time there is another guy at ThoughtWorks, his name is Philippe Hancro. He started developing Selenium Grid. So this is how the Selenium and its components are developed. Okay. So then we'll see why the name Selenium came into picture. You may choose different name, right? Why they have chosen only Selenium. So during that time, there is one company called Mercury. So they released some product for automation. So now the Mercury company is not there. It is being acquired by HP company, Hewlett Packard company. So they started some automation tool. So what Jason Huggins, the person who started this, all this development, he sent an email. So he is the owner, right? So he just developed the internal framework. So what he did after developing, he sent an email to a bunch of people, including the ThoughtWorks internal developers, testers, and some outsiders, saying that you can cure the mercury poisoning by taking the selenium supplements. So what exactly it is? So mercury is a chemical component and selenium is also one chemical component. So both are some chemical elements. So mercury is a poisoning. In a chemistry, you can cure this mercury poisoning by taking selenium supplements. So he just mentioned that with some intention of mercury company also. So that went crazy. And the people who received the email thought that the name of the tool itself is selenium. So they just ran away with it. Once you get the name for one tool and it became popular, later it's difficult to change that name, right? So the popularity, the word of mouth and everything will be gone if you change the tool name suddenly. So what these people did, they just continued with that name itself. So that's how Selenium got its name. So this is the background of Selenium. Now you know about the Selenium, then you can jump into the Selenium course. So thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, HVR Tutorials. Thank you guys. Bye-bye.